Hi everybody, Matt and Tom back with you. Finally, after a few weeks break, we're heading back out on the old Todmorden Pubs trail. Now we've still got two of these to do, one today. We'll film the last one hopefully soon. But today we're going to do, let's class them as the hillside pubs. We're going to start here in Gorksholm, go right up and over Sour Hall, Bacup Road, and even Mankinholes, just to look at what pubs are there. So probably not as many pubs on this one, and some of them have been gone a very long time, but let's once again see what we can find on the way. So we're once again using Barbara's old pub trail book, and we're starting here at the Mason's Arms. And once again, most of these that we're going to walk past today are no longer in use. Mason's Arms is just here. So just by the bridge, this one was the Mason's Arms. It's now Flats, I believe. And on the light above the door, just still say Mason's Arms. This is Navigation Place. This, many years ago, was apparently the Navigation Inn. So the book suggests that at one point there was also a pub here called the Black Bull, which has long since been demolished and also had many changes since then on this site, but we think it was in this location. So we're now leaving Gorksholm behind and we're going to take the long route up, or kind of next to Bacup Road, to our next pub locations. Watched. Hello. So the area we're coming to now is on Bacup Road and it's called Clough Foot. Let's have a look at what's here, because I think there's about at least four pubs here. But many, many years ago, there's none here now. So see if we can successfully track down where they should be. So obviously a lot of these are going to be quite difficult to specifically pinpoint, but we're doing our best. This is the bottom of Sour Hall Road here, and according to the book, at the bottom of the road, this building here, this was a pub called the British Queen. Apparently a bit further up and to the left, was a pub called the Blue Ball. This is a old school, it says here, or a Sunday school. Oh no, school built 1829. So is this called Clough Foot School? So it looks like the next ones might be further up Bacup Road. see if we can find them. Now, obviously, if you do know where they are and we're completely wrong, feel free to tell us. Neither Tom or I are from round here, so yeah, happy to be corrected at all times. So we're now quite a way out of Cloughfoot. I'm not sure the two of the pubs exist anymore. Certainly the Blue Boar, I think, has vanished. We think the last one on this route is just about here. This is the Bay Horse.
Bay Horse. Fab.
So we now have quite a long walk to get to our next pub, literally up and over the top of this hill, past the Astronomy Centre. So we're now heading across Todmorden Moor, past the turbines, hopefully I won't fall over, down into Sourhall. If you ever find yourself walking across the moor, do be careful. All this moorland was mining, and as you can see, there are still some open entrances here, which I think the rabbits have now taken over. But yeah, there's quite a few of these dotted about. So now we're coming down into Sourhall, which is our next stop, and there is at least one building we can show you here. The building over to the right, the long building, that is the former Sourhall Fever Hospital, which was around the end of the 1890s due to a mass outbreak of fever in Todmorden. Over to the left, this was a pub. This was called Dog and Partridge, and you can see it still has a very distinctive shape of a pub. There's also something quite interesting at the back. If we go past the pub, just here to the left, what we find is a huge car park. As you can see, car park. Was the car park for both the pub, and at the back of the building, down those steps there, was a nightclub. And I still find it very baffling. Right up here, seemingly in the middle of nowhere, was a successful nightclub. So it's now private, so I won't go any nearer. But it is interesting that the steps down still there. This is a huge car park. So now we're heading down back into Todmorden, and right in the distance, you probably won't be able to make it out on here, we have the area where our last two pubs are for this video. Just about there is the Shepherd's Rest. Okay, so now we're heading uphill from the canal towards Mankinholes and then Lumbutts. The good thing is, I think the first ones for this video, the two pubs that are here to finish our video for today, are very well known pubs and still very, very busy pubs. See if you know what they are. It's a beautiful evening. This sign here gives the game away. Now this one's quite interesting because it isn't a pub now, don't know if it ever was, but there is, just outside it, look, where this Cross Farm sign is. It's definitely an old pub sign. So I wonder if this was a pub. Not sure. So we're now up on the hill at Nankin Holes. We don't need to walk through the village today. I'm going to drop down to one of the pubs. You can see the little cross on the hill there. We need to head down into the valley. It's a beautiful location here. Studley Pike on the hill there. So we've bypassed Nankin Holes and we're heading down to this building here. This is the Top Brink Inn. A better look of it once we get around the front. A real standout of where the Top Brink is right here in Lumbutts. It's a fantastic location. Things like this are right next to the pub. Fielding's Tower, I call this one. It's possibly wrong. it's the location of my very first video. Now, for anyone who regularly watches my videos, you may have noticed a bit of a difference with this one because I decided to film in landscape instead of my usual portrait. The reason I usually film in portrait is because I believe more people watch videos like this on their phone. So I've tried it a different way today. It does mean you've had lots of me close up. Hopefully got a good look at the buildings we've passed as well. So if you are one of my subscribers, you could just let me know if this is what you want for future videos, or if you prefer me to do it the way I normally do, which I will do for the next few, unless I'm told otherwise. So the last pub we'll see in a second is the very popular Shepherd's Rest. Despite its location up here in the wilds, it survives very well, and a lot of that might be to do with Gadding's Dam, which is about there. That's kind of only half the distance to it. Yeah, Shepherd's Rest. Not easy to see in the sunlight, but it is there, I promise you. To look at it at this side. Okay, so that's our look at the pubs on the hilltops of Todmorden. Coming up next, at some point we will do the big one, Rochdale Road, where most of the pubs seem to be on the map. I've been putting that one off for a while. So I think it might take a while. Okay guys, see you soon. Take care.